Hello, senor!
Hi, everybody, this is Crossover Vanguards. I'm ZaCaptain here. I got Dempster.
Hi!
I got Leon.
Yo!
And I got Victor.
Yo!
Victor is here excited today right now because we got new playmats! So we got a new playmat. So this is our new intro playmat. The old one is kind of getting worn. You can kind of see like the evolution of the colors fading all the way throughout all our unboxing videos.
Just like Love by Ending.
I think that only affects one person only. So, but besides that, so we got a new playmat here. The playmat looks like this is gonna be a new introduction playmat and such. But this is not what we're here for. Yes, this is a nice celebratory thing. But the other thing to celebrate is. Ta-chang! The Blaster Sendou Aichi. Aichi Sendou is
legend deck.
It's the legend deck. So this is the Royal Paladin legend deck for Sendou Aichi. So it's finally dropped here.
Yeah, it's totally unexpected.
Not at all. So, because we've been doing what happened videos based on the stuff that we've seen in here. So.
Yeah.
But anyways, the box is out now. You guys can see the release date right now for both Japanese and English.
Mm-hmm.
English was also, we'll be getting a print of this, although may not be the same items, but I'm not too certain. I don't buy English.
Yeah,
I don't
buy anything. It may be in May.
It may be in May.
Yeah, kind of thing. So this is the IG Legend deck. So the front here, the name right itself, Blasters and IG. Mm-hmm. In other information from there. Aside is a barcode, not relevant to most people. Behind here is the this is the deck list.
Yep.
And the items that you can find in the box here. So so what in here you can find is actually the storage box, which is the whole thing itself. This one is the fighter's counter. Two promo cards, which is two religious holy religious soul saver.
Yep.
That's also included in the set. The deck holder, the clan card. With IG printer on it,
mm-hmm.
And the IG sleeve, so yeah. all from IG with and the deck that he's using in the G next. So
basically, it's actually the same as the other legend deck.
Yep, in a way. So
just a few more extra.
So we're gonna pull out the sleeve here, which has all that information, and we can see from the side it's a beautiful box. Now this thing is no longer have to turn to the light to see that it says the Blaster Sendou Aichi.
Yeah, it's really very obvious now. And then you get to see Aichi and Blaster Blades Crunch too.
This is gonna be the last time we get to do this. Actually.
I hope so, because if the next one is Misaki, right? Please push it. Please.
No, this is the last time we're gonna do it because the trial deck for Nobutama is not gonna have any more storage boxes anymore.
Ah, yes.
Yeah, so that's a shame. So we open up the box, you see all the items inside. The front here we see
the Blaster
Sendou Aichi small decks.
And in Cardfight Vanguard,
yep, G.
Embedded.
Yeah,
and there's a Vanguard circle as well, and Blaster Blade itself.
Yeah, Blaster Blade's
the weapon. Not the person.
Yeah.
So at
on the side you see Epona.
At the back we have the head of Alfred Holy Saver.
Below you see his sword Slapnir.
The horse.
I forget the name already.
So. I also forgot.
Yeah.
Okay, then we have Maron here.
Yeah, little tactician Maron over there. Yeah. So that's what you see on the side. So now let's get into the contents of the stuff.
Okay.
So this is all the information here, the first guide, and plus the playmat.
Yeah, let's see the playmat first.
So now it's no longer Kazuma on the front, it's now Aichi now. So
it wouldn't make sense if Kazuma's there, right?
I don't know, they might, recycle certain things that they have surplus of.
Okay, so as always, the Legend decks have their very own special printer playmats, so you can use this as a poster as well. You can stick this up on the wall, which means I need to find one more space to put this up.
If you decide to.
Yeah, if I decide, I'll probably have to anyway.
And back here, then basically, it's just the history of Sendou Aichi.
And Blaster Blade.
And Blaster Blade together, all of his evolutions throughout the entire season of Cardfight Vanguard.
Just Aichi's evolution.
Aichi's evolution, so. And then also, information on how to play this deck, Legend deck by itself, all the information's over here.
How to play.
How to Blaster Blade.
How to Tachiagarei, Blaster Blade.
Yeah, that's the thing now, thanks guys.
Alright. So we bring the box back in. So here's the promo for Religious Holy Saber. We'll go through the cards as we go along.
Yeah, let's not forget it.
Yeah, let's not forget it. The sleeve itself, which is again same standard printing.
Same
standard printing with this at the side, so it's no longer entirely the character itself, but it's also got some writing.
Yeah,
on the
just
side
in case you don't know what clan Aichi plays, yeah.
Yeah, just in case you don't know what clan Aichi plays.
I think the sleeve now has about, I think, 60 or
65. It has 70 actually. Oh, 70, yeah. There's 70 now, so 70 is the standard over
yeah,
there.
It
so
was, it was yeah, quicker than the Kai Legend.
Oh, yeah, 70,
70, 70, right. So this is the deck holder, so Brasa Bedic Seed on the side, Myriad Soul Saver, Sendou Aichi,
and Alpha Holy Saver.
Alpha Holy Saver, at the bottom says nothing, so there might be some stuff inside, but we'll take a look at it at another time.
And last but not least, we have the divider.
The partition.
Alright, video's over.
Yes, video's over. Bye bye, guys.
Cheers, love.
Nah, okay, not really. Yeah, not really.
Oh, by the way, just in case you guys want to know, this box itself fits up to three of the same sizing for this size.
Like, oh, so yeah, so it's larger in that regard.
So you can put all
three legend decks into one.
It's so funny because the main one is IG. Okay, in any case.
In any case, so this is the deck itself.
Yep.
So we're gonna break down the deck right now. So, this is the IG Legend deck that's broken down, which includes the Religious Soul Saver with promo inside. So, this is the fighter's counter that came with all of that. So, you can see Divine Knight King, Divine Alfred Holy Saver. Divine Knight, so. Then, Blaster Bay with IG 5k, 10k. So, this is actually really nice. Feel the texture of it.
It's been like that all this while, man.
I have no idea. I never really touched any of these.
We don't use it because we have dice.
Yeah, we do have dice, so.
Alright. I'll start using that, that's fine too.
No thanks.
The clan card right here, so we've sent the IG printed on there. And the back Royal Paladin, so it's the same printed as most of the other clan cards as well.
Yep.
But in Legend Decks specifically has this kind of thing. So, how we usually do this, as you guys know, we usually go through the triggers first because the triggers doesn't have that many skills except for one. So we'll go down the line from the triggers first. So the first one we have here is
Liu.
I believe it's Nova Knight Liu.
Yep, Shinsei no Kishi Liu.
So then the next one we have is Pink Comet.
Curse of the what?
Curse of the Flog Out. It's an old Crossbones joke.
The Pink Comet.
Pink Comet Flog Out. Yep.
Pink Comet Flog Out. Now it's basically a curse anyway.
You'll hit you three times faster.
Oh man.
Alright,
next we have Yggdrasil's successor, Elaine.
Yep.
She's now a shaman.
Yeah, she's now a shaman. So. And then we have Maron reprinted yet again.
Sorry.
Margal reprinted. We have Margal reprinted again. but fortunately for us, it's now in a different art.
Yeah, so thank you.
And it's nicer than the older ones we have to say. Yeah. And so in case you're confused by its ability is that when this unit is moved into the soul, from the regard circle, then choose the unit, it gets plus 3k.
Is that yep. this skill? So yes.
It's like this skill, so you pop it any time.
This is like how many times it got reprinted again?
The umpteenth time.
Probably 10.
The 237th.
Okay.
We'll just call it that way. So.
Alright, 237.
Alright, so the next card that we have down the line, so this is the promo that we get from this set, which is a Religious Soul Saver.
Yep.
Holy Dragon Religious Soul Saver. Mm-hmm. So its ability is that when this unit appears in the Vanguard Circle, you may pay the cost, which is counterblast 1, and flip a copy of yourself over.
Yep.
Then if you have a Blaster Heart, then you may choose 3 Rearguards, and those units get plus 5k. Then, if you have two or more units with Blaster in their name, in your soul, this unit gets plus 1 critical.
Yep.
So this is an old card that is reprinted as a promo here. This one, I think it was originally in the first Fighters Collection.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this was what was released for Royal Paladin, and now it's reprinted here. There's a good reason for that, which we will get to eventually.
Yep.
So, moving down the line, so we'll go straight to the strikes that's included in this set.
Okay.
So the first one that we have here is...
Soul Saver.
Myriad. Holy Dragon, Myriad, Soul Saver.
Alright, so what's the skill, Dems?
Alright, its skill is a Vanguard skill, so blast 3. When this unit attacks the Vanguard, if you have an Alfred or Blaster hard card, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose up to 5 of your rear guards during the turn, plus 5k.
Not exactly a very stand trigger friendly card.
It's not a stand trigger friendly card, which is why it makes sense for it to be in this deck, especially with this format being 8 critical, 4 draws.
Yep.
That format. So this one will be kind of okay for this kind of setup. So,
mm-hmm.
But of course, there will be reasons why we want to run stand triggers, which again we'll get to eventually.
Yep.
So just take note that this is Myriad Soul Saver.
Mm-hmm.
The next one that we have is 4 copies of them. This is Alfred. Holy Saver.
Yes.
Yeah, so I mentioned the full name. This is Divine Knight King Alpha Holy Saver.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so its ability is that once per turn, the first one is actually it's only one skill. So it's an active skill, once per turn, GB2. You counterblast one, you flip a G unit with the same name as this unit, flip it face up, then you discard one card from your hand. So, if you have an Alfred or Blaster Heart, once you pay all that cost, then you choose a unit with Blaster Blade in his name, choose a Rearguard with Blaster Blade in his name, it gets plus 3000 power and the skill. When this unit attacks for the first time, does battle for the first time, this unit can perform Twin Drive.
Yep.
So again, that's the point that we made as to why you want to place 10 triggers in this deck, because if you have a Blaster Blade that actually checks as 10 trigger, you can restand that Blaster Blade.
Yep.
Because it is a rear guard, you can choose to restand it again. Well, you won't be able to prompt Twin Drive because it only happens once, but it's still another attack that I would say.
Yep.
Yeah. So that's in terms of the strikes. Vic, what do you think of the strikes so far?
Strikes so far, the Alfred gives the added advantage for, because you actually plus 2 on the rear guard Blaster Blade. So your hand instantly increases to 5 regardless.
Yep. Not only that, it gives you 2 more chances to check whatever triggers that you need for whatever rear guards that you have. In this case, Blaster Blade, because it's very centered around that.
And plus, not to mention that you can afford to attack with the other side first before you attack with the Blaster Blade, since it did say first battle for this unit.
Yes.
So it doesn't matter who goes first.
Yes.
Yeah, it doesn't matter who goes first. So as long as it attacks once.
It's different from what was the other card's name?
Shibaraku Buraid for Murakumo.
Yes. So do take note on that. This one is very different from that.
Mm-hmm. So because that one says that you need to if it's the first battle when it's attacking, then go from there. So that's so that's the strikes, Mirat Soul Saver, Religious Soul Saver, Alfred Holy Saver. We go to the G-Guardian right now, so this is an old friend of ours from back in the day. This is...
This
insulting
is...
Insulting you.
Great Flash is old.
Yeah, so according to Leon, it's insulting
insult,
us.
Yeah, great Flash insult.
Great segue, by the way.
Alright, so her skill list. When this unit appears on Guardian Circle, if you have an Alfred or Blaster Vanguard, you may pay the cost, which is kind of plus 1. If you do, for every rear guard during the battle, this unit plus 5k.
This is a very good card.
Very good card.
This maximum is actually... plus 25k.
Maximum plus 25k, she also becomes a 40k guard.
And then, currently, this is like the biggest G Guardian so far.
And then, one added point is that I noticed it's not a continuous skill, so if you have two grade 2s in the front row, let's say if you face off against Shadow, you can actually intercept with those two units.
Yes,
yeah,
it
and
brings
then,
up to a 50k shot.
Correct. Yeah, so it checks for that moment when it appears in the Guardian Circle and you paid the cost already.
Correct.
Then from there, it checks if you have 5, you get 5 from there. Then once you intercept, it's no longer continuous like Androgyus. So it's an additional, it keeps the Guardian Circle from there.
Correct.
Although it sounds all high and mighty, but there is one downside about the Alfred deck that's quite notorious for is that they don't actually have a lot of
counter charges.
Counter charging,
and the fact that this only works for Alfred or Blaster.
And
so, Ultima players, good luck.
GG.
It doesn't call as bad as good as Automo, so it does have its own problems.
Okay, like give and take lah.
Give and take.
Give and take from there. So alright, so let's go down to the card that will make Victor squeal.
That's a very weak squeal.
Yeah. Squeal, yeah.
So
it did not exceed our expectations.
Rightfully so, because this card is Blaster Blade XC.
Quite expectations. 2 grade 3 to overlay.
Overlay,
To exceed summon.
To exceed.
To connect.
Okay, that's enough Yu-Gi-Oh references right there. So.
Alright, so Cap was the skill.
Alright, so remember what I mentioned about the strikes having the Saber in their name?
Yep.
Because the first skill that Saber. The first skill that Blaster Blade XC has is that during your turn, if you strike the G unit with Saber in its original name, you may pay the cost, which is counterblast 1. If you do, then you may search your deck for a unit with Blaster Blade in its name, reveal it, add it to your hand, and shuffle your deck. So that's the first skill. That's why all the strikes that we have here all say Saver.
Yep.
All say Savers. It also has a second skill, which is iconic to Blaster Blade. So when this unit appears in the Vanguard or Rearguard Circle, you may pay the cost, which is counterblast 1. If you do, choose a grade 1 or above Rearguard and retire it.
Mm-hmm.
So which is...
It's very better because you can actually retire grade 1s.
You can retire great ones,
like finally.
That, which
finally.
Is something that Blaster Blade cannot do. There's always been some sort of restrictions added to all versions of Blaster Blade that's in there. Well, some needing a Seeker Vanguard, others needing
like a Liberator Vanguard. Liberator Vanguard.
Grade 2 above. The only one that can truly destroy everything, right, is Blaster Blade, but only when you ride it, only when you touch Tachiagarei,
Brastabraid. Thanks, guys. So Vic, I have a question to ask you. Does this exceed your expectations?
Actually, it does. Because, in the event if you are really rushed, you can actually call it as a rearguard and then add an attack. When it's 11k, it's an 11k.
Yeah, there's no restrictions also.
There's no restriction at all.
Mm-hmm. So that's that's the neat thing with Blaster Bay Exceed lah. That's the way that it does. Even if you call it the regular circle, it still keeps the ability, the iconic too.
Yep. Mm. And might I add, just before we move on to the next card, is that in comparison to the other two legend base vanguards, this is one of the this is the most versatile among the two.
Yes.
Because Diablo, the rival card of Blaster Bay, had some serious issue with you need to strike to a Diablo, and there isn't a lot of Diablos.
There's
only
that,
two, in fact.
There's only two Diablos that you can strike to. That's one. Not only that, also it's a strike ability. It's strike ability. Yeah, the strike skill that it has only works for Phantom Master Diablo.
Correct. Yes. So most of the time, you really sit there and just think about life.
I've also mixed feelings about this card because it actually doesn't have a GB2 skill.
Yes, it doesn't, but for good reasons also. With skills like this, you really want GB2.
It's good enough, it's good as it is. So
yes,
we have mixed feelings about
it. I guess Legend actually stood in between the two of the three.
Dragon Overlord, the Legend. So it stands between the two of three because Dragon Overlord, while it has a nice skill or that turns itself into the strike in case you're in a pinch.
Yep.
However, compared to Blaster Bait can shine much more shinier than the hot fires of Kagero.
Yeah, okay, so we digress too much.
We have digressed too much. Let's get back to this.
Flames. Yes.
Another old friend.
Can we skip this card?
we have no choice. Despite the history that we have with this card, if all previous iterations card, we have to go through it as what we are here at Crossover Vanguard. So, Dempster, the name is, because I can't remember the name.
Okay, I don't know the English one. The Japanese one is Mokan no Soken Palomides.
I think it's Blazing Twin Swords Palomides. So, I didn't realize Palomides had long hair and became Bishonen.
Yeah.
Oh,
it should be so
bara.
No, his grade 2 was Bishi.
Grade 2 was a bit
Bishi. I think this is the grade 2 version.
Okay. Alright, we're digressing again. So, its ability is Vanguard Rearguard Circle Auto with a GB1.
Yep.
So, on GB1, when this unit attacks the Vanguard, if you have two other grade 3 or above units on your field, for the battle, this unit plus 10k.
Mm-hmm.
This one has a lot of history for us, which I think we will talk more with over on Discord with some of the other regards, or I might even bring up on a radio show, one of our radio shows, right? There when we appear next time. So we will share that stories probably at those times.
But yes. Before we move on, can I just point out something very important about this card?
Okay. Yeah.
It's not my head or anything. Imagine you write up this card and call two more.
Yeah, it works.
Yeah, it works.
But it's GP1.
Yeah, it's GP1. So
you're gonna have a bad time.
You're all gonna have a bad time if this thing shows up. So
anyways, the skill is quite dope because it's actually extra guarding because it's plus 10k.
It's a good step up from the original Palamedes as well because the one only specifies grade 3. Grade 3. So if you strike, that you lose 1 3k.
Yeah,
you lose 1 grade 3. But for this case, it's grade 3 and above, so your strike still counts.
Strike still counts, also. Although GB1, so that's the only hindrance right there. So.
Oh, you strike already, you get GB1, what are you talking about?
You get the point.
So. I know.
Moving on.
Blind man.
The blind man is here.
So this is the silent hero. Silent warrior.
No, champion of silence.
Oh, okay, fine.
Yeah, I got a translation.
Timoku no Yushi Galatine.
Champion of silence, Galatine.
You know, before we move on to his skills and all, I'm kind of wondering why this deck doesn't have 50 of this. If you guys get the reference, please give us a thumbs up. Okay, but anyway, the only other thing that he retains is the 10k base power, which is very, very, very unique for all grade 2s because he's the only one that retains that.
And then his ability, so yeah.
Yeah, and he sort of fused with Gordon, I guess?
Yeah.
Gordon? Why I say that is because his continuous skill, in the Guardian Circle GB1, this unit gets plus 5k shield. Mm-hmm. So, not only just from intercepting, but from guarding from your hand as well. So, as long as it appears in Guardian Circle, he gets plus 5k shield.
Yeah, his Clay looks stupid.
Yeah, he makes Clay look stupid. So, his other skill is a Vanguard Rearguard skill. If you do not have a unit, in your Vanguard or Rearguard Circle with Blaster in his name, this unit gets a minus 2k.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a first as well, considering all other cards in other Legend decks as well.
Yeah,
this is like the only one that has a minus power.
Yeah, but at least during the ride up, so yeah. Vanguard Rearguard Circle, so you need to have a Blaster on the field, otherwise it'd be 8k through and through. So that's something to take care of, and it's probably something that you don't want to ride up to despite the 10k.
But you're Aichi, you're definitely right to something.
To brush the braid.
Yeah, to brush the braid.
We'll get to brush the braid soon, because it's still down the line. So we still got the others that we need to go through. Mm-hmm. So the one that we have here, this is... Knight of Virtue Bedivere. So, yeah, so this is Knight of Virtue Bedivere. So his ability is that the first one, he has two. So when this unit attacks the Vanguard, if you have an Alfred or a Blaster unit in the Vanguard or Regard Circle on GB1, then for the battle, this unit gets +3k. So it becomes so this is your basic 4k attacker, much like how Bedivere used to be for blasters.
Yep.
The second skill that it has is that when this unit appears in the Regard Circle, choose a unit named Knight of Benevolence. Knight of Benevolence K. Yeah, choose one in the same column as this unit. Then for that turn, this unit +2k, and if you have done so, you may soul charge. You soul charge one. Yep. Not you may, you have to soul charge one.
That unit +2k lah.
Yeah. So this is Bedivere. We'll get to his counterpart very soon, but this is kind of like a step up from the previous Bedivere that was released, which is just if you have a Blaster Vanguard, then this unit gets plus.
4k.
Yeah, it's kind of funny that in comparison with the Claudius counterpart, Doran, it's a little lackluster.
Yes, for different reasons, because this is more reliant on calling to get the soul charge, whatever you need, whereas for Claudius and Doran combo, all you need is for them to be on the same column and just attack.
Yes, and they just start boosting each other. So.
Yeah, and they start boosting each other.
And Doran and Claudius is a powerhouse very quickly.
Yes.
They're almost broken at the time.
Correct. Almost broken at the time, but then again, you know, they both boost each other. So.
Good flare.
They both boost each other, so.
Yeah. And speaking of boosting.
No hope! No hope, trumpet here!
Speaking of boosting, so I don't know how we transition from no from that to no hope, because boosting again. So, this is Star Hope Trumpeteer. Thank you for the fanfare. Thank you for the no hope fanfare. So Star Hope Trumpeteer's ability is that GB1, counterblast 1, when this unit appears in the Regard Circle from hand, you have Alfred or Blaster Vanguard, you may pay the cost. If you do, search a deck for one unit. Search your deck for one card, call it the Regard Circle, and for the turn that unit gets +3k and shuffle your deck. Mm-hmm. So this one straight up calls any unit, but as long as you have a Blaster Vanguard or Blaster or Alfred Vanguard, then you're able to do the calling from there.
Yep.
But this thing can call anything. So I guess the idea behind that being there is to get Bedivere or K out.
Anyone that you need.
Any unit that you need right there, which includes the next card that we have there,
Only one copy.
Only one copy of because it's Aichi. So yep.
So this is let's together. One, two, three.
Burasta Buraid.
I like our synergy. Okay, so because he's in the deck, we have to explain his skills already. They're like for the upteenth time.
The one thing I want to point out is that this is actually a full art card. SP print treatment. SP print
with triple R foiling.
Yes. With triple R foiling. So,
Just to know where the SP came from was from the first BTO 1 SP print.
Hexagonal design.
Hexagonal design. So basically, this is the Blaster Bait. This is supposedly the Blaster Bait that IG has had since Kai gave to him when he was a small boy. Way back in season 1.
Yeah, all these foil cards all have the same foiling.
In a way, so
but it's a bit special for
Blaster Blade. So, anyways, just to go through his skill, if you're new to Vanguard, I've never heard of Blaster Blade ever. So he's got two abilities. The first one is Counterblast 2. When this unit appears in the Vanguard Circle, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose one of your opponent's Regards and retire it. The second ability is when this unit appears in the Regard Circle, then if you have a Royal Paladin Vanguard, you may pay the cost, which is Counterblast 2. If you do, choose one of your opponent's Grade 2 and above Regards and retire it. Mm-hmm. So that is Blaster Blade in a nutshell. So you can retire anything as long as you get into the Vanguard Circle. So that's why people would write him, especially if they have two counterblasts to use.
Yep.
But if they also have two counterblasts to use and they've got a target that you really don't like early in the game or late in the game for that matter, you can call it the Vanguard Circle counterblast to destroy that grade 2 or grade 3.
Wow, so the best anti rush during the early days.
Yes. In the early days.
It's a rush punisher, I would say.
Definitely. So that's all the grade 2s that's showcased so far. So we move on to the grade 1s.
It's a very young Wingull, because he's got all his youth with him, hence the name Wingull Youth. Okay, that was very long. Alright, so his skill is when this unit's attack or boost hits the Vanguard, check the top 7 of your deck and search for up to one card with Blaster Blade in his name. Add it to your hand and shuffle your deck. If you add the card to your hand, move this unit into the soul.
Yeah. So this is a way to actually help you find any blaster blades that you might want to look for in the top 7.
Yep.
So, but of course, the attack needs to hit, which is the barrier right there.
Yeah.
And not only that, you lose Ring Out Youth if you actually find the blaster blade added to your hand and you move into Soul.
Yes.
Although, considering what Myriad Soul Saver does, you probably will want that Soul for that reasoning. So, kind of like the idea. And of course, the Soul Charge is really specific to what it is. So, with Bedivere. Speaking of Bedivere, let's talk about his current partner right now, which is Knight of Benevolence K.
Okay.
Alright. It's K, guys. It's K. So, Dempster, what's the skill for K?
Alright, K skill is a Rearguard skill, GB1. When this unit attacks the Vanguard, if you have a Blaster or Alfred unit in a Vanguard or Rearguard circle, during the battle, this unit plus 3k, so it becomes a 10k attacker. I guess pretty much like his old counterpart as well.
Mm-hmm.
And this other skill is, when this unit appears on a Rearguard circle, choose a Knight of Virtue Bedivere in the same column as this unit, during the turn plus 2k, and if you choose, counter charge 1.
Mm-hmm. So this is
similar to Claudas and Doreen as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a Legion art drawn by Hagia Kaoru. So thank you, Kaoru-san. Hagia-san, I'm sorry. Sumimasen deshita.
The only downside about this card is that it's not as consistent as the other two counterparts.
Correct.
Yeah, the other two counterparts, which is again Claudas and Doreen.
Which I pointed out earlier.
But on the plus side, it gives a counter charge ability, so it kind of
But here's the problem, because you can only get one or the other. So you cannot have both of the same world.
Not unless you actually mod up the
same time.
Yeah, not unless you mod your deck where you actually have the ability to call them both at the same time. That's when
Cannot call. Oh, no.
Bye guys. I'm sorry.
But
I'm not a Royal Paladin.
Zell Alfred can call.
Zell Alfred can call the Legion for.
Why would you want to use that now?
Well, if one brought these two, then
okay,
budget will be
lah.
So
get yourself killed.
That's true. All right, so we move on to the one unit that's forever not dying.
Chisana Gunshi Maron,
Little Tactician Maron. So this is nothing like the little
Chisana referee.
The little referee that we have here. Although I realize that you actually can't see that thing. So, so its ability is GB1. When this unit appears in the Rearguard circle from your hand, if you have an Alfred or Blaster Vanguard, you may pay the cost, which is counter plus 1. If you do search a deck for one card, call it the Rearguard circle, then you need plus 3k and shuffle your deck. That seems familiar.
That seems very familiar. I wonder. Oh, well.
I wonder which one is the more hopeful to do.
Oh well.
I wonder which one is the more hopeful to do. Really, really gets my goat. So Maron is back in this set. So everything here is nostalgic to old players from season 1.
But this is kind of different, because among the three legend deck, this is the only set that have two cards that have exactly the same skill.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Kai legend and the Ren legend didn't have something, they have similar, but they're not the same. Just to pick out the unique of the two other decks is that the Ren legend deck, they have Star Call, when it's called, so far it's called a great one.
Yep.
Then while the Kai one, they have the Berserk Dragon that basically when you attack, when you're level 4 overall attacks, the counterparts on destroy. So they each have their own unique, so this is actually special on its own as well.
Mm-hmm.
More like the character anime-ish kind of gimmick in the deck.
It gives you more reason to call out both K and Bedivere as well.
But downside is that because it's counterblast one,
it's heavy lah.
It's heavy.
Yeah. It's quite heavy indeed.
So just like the little tactician, you gotta really think like a tactician on what to call and where to call and when to call.
Yeah, so you can't blaze it like a Vanguard before with this one.
Alright. Don't blaze it like the Holy Saver, Alpha Holy Saver.
Alright, speaking of blazers, this one has a lot of fire to it. So this is...
What kind of fire you mean?
This is... This is Epona, but the name is...
Tenyu no Erabite, Epona.
Went from critical to a PG.
Yep. And this PG is different from the previous PGs in the Legend deck, because its ability is that when this unit appears in the Guardian Circle from your hand, you may pay the cost, which is discard one card from your hand. Mm-hmm. If you do, then choose the unit that's being choose one of your Vanguards that's being attacked, and that unit cannot be hit. Then if you have it doesn't say N actually, so but basically if you have a same copy of it in the drop zone, you can't charge one.
Yep.
Yeah, so this is the reason why it's different is because if you can tell from the amount of counterparts that we see in this video, There's actually a lot of counterblasts. There's a lot of units that actually use a lot of counterblasts here. So there's a reason why they had to switch this to a countercharger. So
yes.
So if you buy this set, you guarantee yourself three. You get yourself a full playset of countercharging. So which is universally useful in most decks, especially for Royal decks and such. So.
Yeah. If you don't have Only Hand Guardian, this is a better way to get it.
Mm. But, and at the same time, it's also special again because the other two of the legend deck is a drop. And it's a draw drop
kind. Yeah.
So,
but for good reasons, because those were previously very heavily centered on drawing.
Correct.
Like for Nivan and Elmo, you draw, but in this case, it's a critical. So
it's critical that you use.
Yes.
And at the beginning, when it was first announced, we were a little thick. It's like, why is this so special? Then when everything started release, I was like, oh,
that's okay, why. Everything all makes sense now because everything has a counterblast. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Almost everything.
And IG being IG the way it is. Alright, so the last card that we have in this set here. So this is
Blue Skull Bakgal.
Blue Skull Bakgal. So, hey, Bakgal and First Vanguard, although a different kind of First Vanguard.
The not so good one.
Yeah, the one that was forever banned since the start of Vanguard.
The one
that
got away.
Blue Skull Bakgal skill is X skill, GB1, counterblast 1, and move this unit into soul. Search your deck for an Alfred or Blaster card, add it to your hand, and shuffle your deck. Mm. So it's very similar to Lizard Hero Undo and Fubar Brave.
Mm-hmm. So it says for the specific namesake of the deck itself.
Yes.
So in this case, this one is Blaster or Alfred.
Mm-hmm.
And also, it's just the same as for Undo for Overlord and Fubar Brave for Blaster Duck.
Yes.
So you can actually find those, add them to your hand, and after you can use them for a future turn. For this one, it's a bit more universally much more useful considering what Blaster Blade XE can do, what Blaster Blade can do.
Yep. And not only that, you can use it in an Alfred deck as well. So
yeah,
if you don't have Elrond, you can use this.
Exactly. So
Undo is better. Because Undo just says Overlord.
We know there's 7 different other Overlords.
In comparison with the 3, like, and plus I can search for Phantom Blaster Overlord if I wanted.
It provided if they actually format last time.
Why would you do that?
But Bakgal gives you the choice of two different units.
Yes, correct.
Bakgal gives you the choice of different units. So if you guys can tell, this actually is not only just a Blaster Blade deck, but it's also an Alfred deck as well.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the cards in here, you can actually use it for Alfred Oath at the same time.
Yep.
Which is actually universally, that is actually much more versatile.
Yes.
It's much more versatile in that regard because not only can you use this for Blaster, but you can also use this for Alfred as well.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I can expect some people actually buying like two boxes, one just to build up for Blaster, and they want to actually build up for Alfred. Or they can just get one, try and get the two, and combine the two together and make it shine, as you say. So,
but at the same time, if you're building an Alfred deck with all these cards in mind, you have to keep in mind that because Alfred specifies Swordsman of Light as well, so if you don't have those cards, you're gonna have a little bit of a trouble trying to get those cards off.
Yeah, which is why your fallback is Blaster. So
yes,
that's the common thread that ties everything
together.
You know
what would be funny? Blaster something Alfred.
No, push it out, please. No.
Honestly, initially, right, my thoughts before the legend that came out was that Alpha would be a Blaster unit.
Right.
Mm. So yeah, that's fine in itself. So right. So if you guys are looking forward to how these decks actually function in a match, we do have matches lined up for this deck specifically. So we're gonna see how it's gonna do in its raw state as it is.
Mm-hmm.
So check back to Crossover Vanguards and do make sure to check that out. So if you wanna check that out, do consider subscribe to us here at Crossover Vanguards for shenanigans that we're gonna do with this deck, all sorts of shenanigans that we are gonna do.
Yep.
And ring that bell as well. So you can make sure that you get those shenanigans right there at the point in time when we need it.
Mm-hmm.
When we actually upload our videos, both regular and impromptu. At the same time, also do follow us on all of our socials. We're on Facebook, Crossover Vanguards. We're on Twitter, Crossover VGS. We got our blog, CrossoverVanguards.com. We can see that profiles, event coverages, and many of the other stuff that we cannot do here on the channel in video form. Also do join us on Discord so that you can actually you can actually talk to us directly, so we're usually there almost every day, and you can actually hang out with the rest of rear guards and get stuff talking, going there, everything related to Vanguard and everything else under the sun. And as well, if you like what you see here across the Vanguards and would like to support the show directly, do consider supporting us on Patreon so that we can actually get more varied content out, more ambitious projects out here across the Vanguards, so that we can show them to you guys, because we like to do many different things here. Such as radio shows and all that other stuff. So, any final words in regards to the IG Legend deck?
Nope.
But look forward to the fights.
Yeah. Look forward to the fights.
Blaster Blade. soon.
Yeah, he plans to work some Buster bait soon. So, with all that said, thank you guys again for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!